So just in time for the start of the men's final day of the Tour de Ski, the climb up the Alpe Chamise,
top of the time, but then he really burns up.
Well, there is Dürr just getting underway. No number four because Alex Harvey has withdrawn. Cali Halvorsen, who was in second place in the Tour, shows off the starting 7:209 off the pace of the leaders. And the defending champion still...
Jespersen's got the gap down to 109, and it was 126 when he started.
Well, I think he is. I think he's down in fourth place. Cali Halvorsen is there for Sweden. A podium still possible for the Swedes if he can pick up his rate. But we might find that Sjurodde is the man who comes through to make it a 1-2-3-4 for the Norwegians.
For me,
this is the fight for the minor places. 1, 2 and 3 are taken at the moment. But this group working so still well within his limits. Now Dürr is starting to accelerate, and this perhaps is where we're going to see something spectacular from the...
Don't think. Keep the prudent. Keep at this level that I can just about go with.
And here's the man of the thought line split, the Norwegians on the podium. And Dürr has pulled away from that chasing group. Nice short skip. Almost 40 seconds. Because we watched Dürr of Austria need to get closer and closer to Ben and Norton. Oh my goodness, he's getting desperately close. He's flying up the hill.
I think that's Norton going to be passed again very soon. The momentum here from Dürr from Austria is just incredible. Probably setting the fast for the climb.
Norton still in third, but it's looking harder and harder. And here comes Johannes Dürr of Austria, who drives past Norton. Puts in a concerted effort to make sure that he makes the break. But Nortug suddenly finds something special. I'm not sure how long this effort from Nortug is going to last, but he would love to finish in third and complete the clean sweep.
Well, Nortug is a dream. He's killing the muscle, screaming in the muscle. Stay with this man, and if anybody can stay with the athlete that is, it's Ben and Nortug.
We've seen him do it before, Mike, and it lasts for 50 to 100 metres. But man who lives in Oslo, he's 29 years old, so he's coming to the prime. He is already the overall World Cup leader, and he's going to have a huge lead at the end of today because he picks up 400 World Cup points, the normal allocation, not to fight. And Johannes Dürr, who we predicted from his performance last year, where he recorded a time of 30:19 on the Alpe Chamise, it looked as though he could do the same, and he's done exactly that. If he hadn't lost so much ground in the first 3 days, he could have been a contender for the title.
So much so, 1:05 behind, he started 2 minutes behind, almost a minute full by.
He takes over from Alexander Lektor. And there you see the time, 30 pounds over the last 9 days. Mike Andrew Musgrave, how do you think that's going to work for his confidence as we have another look at the top three?
I think it'll be a real good build-up. When you compete in the top 30, well, against the world's best, then you really are in that top bracket. And it will release confidence in all his performances in the future. I am so sure of that.
And how long before you go and try and persuade him to...